So this should be another speak about DOS attacks. And it was interesting that it's this DOS attacks that we suffered in March was not unusual, not strong, but it got a really big media attention. So that's something that makes this these attacks quite extraordinary. Well, so let's start with my presentation. Let me introduce myself once again. I'm Jaromir Talir from CZ.NIC, which is a Czech domain registry. And I want to talk about 1 week in March that made a lot of network engineers in our country unhappy and brought them a lot of headaches. I will walk through what were targets of attacks, what types of attacks it was, how we cooperated during mitigation of these attacks, what were reactions to these attacks, and some suggested countermeasures, and at the end some conclusions. Well, so let's start with who was target of these attacks. It was surprising that there was no special one target of these attacks, but it was systematic. There was systematic selection of targets, and it started on Monday 4th, with DOS attacks against most popular news servers we have. There was about 4 or 5 sites, and it continues on Tuesday. The target of attack was one of the biggest portal in Czech Republic, Seznam, which is something like Yandex here. It's really the big portal. On Wednesday, the few most popular banks were under attack. On Thursday, two major mobile operators were under attack. And on Friday, it stopped. The timing was usually 2 hours in the morning and 2 hours afternoon. So at least the attackers were fair enough to give engineers time for lunch. Well, the result was that usually websites were inaccessible, but a lot of interconnected systems were also inaccessible. Like we have a public transport SMS ticketing system for buying public transport tickets online via SMS, which was not accessible. Some e-commerce services were not accessible also. Actually, this was not popular DNS attacks, which was spoken earlier in the session, but it was TCP SYN flood attacks. So this targets were attacked by a lot of SYN packets with spoofed source addresses. There was the major attack, but there were some another attempts using different kind of attack, which is a TCP reflection attack, where attacker is using some routers and put target address into source of these TCP SYN packets. So they will receive a lot of SYNACK packets going from these routers. The strength was not big. We found out that it was about not more than 1.5 megapackets per second, and not even more than 1 gig of traffic. And but it was found out later that the problem was in a badly configured load balancers and firewalls. And such traffic exhausted their tables for in TCP step for for this for sorry for setting up TCP connection. Why we are involved, why we were involved in this is because CZ.NIC operates for last 2 years national CCERT team, which is Computer Security Incident Response Team, on behalf of our government. And it's mainly used for incident reporting and some coordination and maintaining contacts and things like this. And during this attack, we were quite a lot of contacted by network engineers asking what's going on, how they can what they can do against this attack. So we function as sort of information hub and trying to help them find out the ways how to get rid of this problem. We also received some data from these attacks, so we did some data analysis. And of course, we did some media communication also. We can say that we found out that there was a quite a good cooperation between targets of attacks and their ISPs, and the ISPs helped them to somehow solve the problem by filtering traffic and things like this. Quite soon, we found out that the source of the traffic is hidden somewhere, probably behind the local transit network RETIN. And but people involved in this communication were trying to reach somebody in RETIN, but they failed. And later, they just received information that there is no way how to find out the source of attack. As I said at the beginning, these attacks have a really big media impact. For a few days, there was a title pages in newspapers, who will be the next target. Everybody was quite afraid what will happen next day. And even evening news headlines were discussing this, and people discussed it in pubs, and everybody discussed this problem that internet is something wrong, that somebody can so easily put down these popular websites. Of course, police and a police president announced that they will investigate who is behind this attack. I don't know about any progress in this investigation. And surprisingly, that these attacks was almost at the same time where our government is finishing a controversial anti-cybercrime law, which is right now discussed. So there are a lot of speculations who is behind that attack. What are some countermeasures that was discussed after these attacks? And of course, that the problem is that these devices doesn't provide or didn't have enabled SYN cookies technology, or the way how to mitigate the problem is with this kind of attack. But there was also quite a big initiative by our peering point, NIC CZ. During their workshops, they suggested two methods how to for the networks connected to this peering point. And one was a sort of remote triggered black hole filtering platform that they will assign one specific IP address, which will be used to black hole selected traffic from some peers. And the other one was that they will establish sort of secure VLAN that all people connect or networks connected to this VLAN must sign that they have some security countermeasures, like implementing BCP 38, which prevents these attacks. they must provide 20-hour NOG, or they must be contactable. And if networks will be connected with in parallel with unsecure and secure VLAN, they can easily leave in case of attack the unsecure VLAN and stay within the islands of secure networks. Well, there is a last slide with conclusion that probably nobody knows who is the source of that attack. Definitely, there must be somebody who quite knows about the internet ecosystems in Czech Republic because of selection of targets. And well, we found out that there is quite good cooperation inside our country to how to help these targets to get rid of these attacks. So,
thank you, Jaromir. We are running a little short on time.
We're short in time, so just one question. Alexander Lamin.
Openly on such a sensitive question, and I'm really impressed with level of cooperation in Czech Republic with on this subject. We don't have such cooperation in Russia. Secondly, I would recommend that you some point outs for Russian search to go and help with the investigation. This is important. And guys, you're just about to invent national cybersecurity strategy. Congratulations on that.
Thank
this
you.
Is safe VLAN. This is the right thing to do.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Amir. So we have. Thank you guys. Sorry.